James Webb Space Telescope reached operational temperature. What now? On December 25th of 2021, something incredible happened. The James Webb Telescope was launched. This event is going to change science and our entire understanding of the world. An observational challenge in astrophysics will be finally solved with the help of this powerful instrument. James Webb is going to study the earliest ancient universe, and it will unveil so many different mysteries. Generations of astronomers will work on JWST data reduction and will try to provide us with new knowledge about the universe. Since its launch in December, the telescope has undergone adjustments and has been getting ready to begin its official mission. At the same time, it was cooling down. The cooling of a telescope is essential to its mission because if the telescope is too hot, unwanted defects can appear on the images it's going to take. Of course, we don't want that to happen. Today, we're going to talk a little bit more about some of the recent updates and discover what the James Webb Telescope has been up to during the last period and, more importantly, what is going to happen during summer and by the end of the year. Welcome to James Webb's DWARF II, a portable digital telescope. It's intelligent and features the latest innovation in astronomy. From one of the world's leading pioneers of cutting-edge products that break limits, today we bring you the latest innovation, DWARF II, the portable digital telescope that is unlike anything you've ever seen before. Are you an amateur astronomer, birdwatcher, wildlife photographer, or just a photography enthusiast that needs to capture things you can't get close enough to, like a ball game? Well, DWARF II is exactly what you need. Unlike traditional telescopes that are bulky and costly, DWARF II allows you to explore your interests without hassle. For astronomy lovers, automatically track and capture deep sky objects with just one click. Forget about searching the skies for your target galaxy or nebula and having to move with it. Our telescope does everything for you. DWARF II's intelligent hardware platform that comes with edge computing capabilities means that you can quickly find your target with powerful dual-angle cameras and intelligently track and shoot moving objects without any manual input. Plus, we have included APIs that allow you to create new gameplay. And for a convenient and enjoyable user experience, DWARF II can be operated wirelessly using your smartphone. Just install the DWARF app and use your phone to focus, rotate the angle, adjust the pitch, switch camera modes, and much more. So whether you need to record that rocket launch, monitor your farm from a distance, or just shoot a panorama, DWARF II is exactly what you need. Back our project today and enjoy 21% off on your DWARF II telescope. The recently released images from JWST show the quality of the image and the sharpness of four of the main instruments on the telescope. Scientists can see that everything has been finally aligned. And everything is aligned perfectly. JWST also seems to be working just as expected, and maybe better. In fact, every tested instrument is doing better than the team was expecting, and needless to say, it seems to be producing amazing images. Differently from what a planet does around the Sun, or from what the Moon does around the Earth, the James Webb is orbiting around a point in space. This point is actually a dynamical equilibrium point, and it is called L2, named after the mathematician Lagrange, who gave a description of such a dynamical system. We actually have five such equilibrium points in the Sun-Earth system, and they are points in space around which we place our telescopes to better observe the universe. You can find L2 on the line connecting the Sun and the Earth from the Earth's side. L1 lies on the same line, but between the Sun and the Earth, while L3 is on the Sun's side. L4 and L5 are more special points and are called equilateral points, because they are found to form a triangular shape with the Sun and the Earth. Due to their positions, different Lagrangian points can be used to observe different parts of the universe. For example, a satellite orbiting around L1 is good to observe the Sun and monitor solar spots. Instead, one placed in L2 has an advantageous point of view on outer space and stars, as JWST has. L2 is located approximately 1.5 million kilometers from planet Earth. JWST's actual position varies between 250,000 kilometers and 832,000 kilometers from L2 as it orbits, keeping it out of both Earth and Moon's shadow. By way of comparison, Hubble orbits 550 kilometers or 340 miles above Earth's surface, and the Moon is roughly 400,000 kilometers or 250,000 miles from Earth. Objects near this Sun-Earth L2 point can orbit the Sun in synchrony with the Earth, allowing the telescope to remain at a roughly constant distance. What we can say is that while JWST was orbiting L2, in March, approximately a couple of months ago, the mirrors were officially aligned. This is an important step for a telescope because if we can't align the mirrors, we simply can't take images of the universe. Or if mirrors are misaligned, our pictures are going to be really bad ones. In this image, we can see the first image visible from JWST. It shows a random star. This star is in the middle of nowhere and wasn't particularly bright either. It seems to be just an image like any other, but if you take a better look at it, you will soon realize that many, many galaxies are found behind the star. Take into consideration that this was just a random image with no particular observational aim, based on a very preliminary observation. Do you have any idea on how many different galaxies we're going to be discovering during the next months or years? I honestly can't wait for James Webb to be fully operational. I'm also sure that you have noticed the spikes around the star. What are they? Why are they formed? Is this an image defect? Well, these spikes are technically image defects, and one can have different spikes depending on the shape of the mirror of the telescope. The James Webb mirror is a hexagonal-shaped mirror formed by smaller mirrors. Such spikes do not only affect the main star, but also all the other stars in the telescope's field of view. But don't worry, astronomers know how to extract these spikes and how to get rid of them. It's all about data reduction. Once you know quite well the properties of your telescope, you can in general get rid somehow of instrumental defects. The real news about James Webb, however, is that over a week ago, the agency announced that the combination of the sun shield and the active cryocooler that's responsible for cooling down the mid-infrared instrument, also called MIRI, has officially succeeded. Now the telescope temperature is about 6 to 7 Kelvin. This is its operational temperature. 6 Kelvin is an extremely low temperature, so close to absolute zero, the ideal case for a telescope not affected by instrumental heating. In short term, now the telescope is fully operational and ready to observe. But more interesting news came from Gaia. Gaia is an ambitious mission to chart a three-dimensional map of our galaxy, the Milky Way, in the process revealing the composition, formation, and evolution of the galaxy. Gaia will provide unprecedented positional and radial velocity measurements with the accuracies needed to produce a stereoscopic and kinematic senses of about 1 billion stars in our galaxy and throughout the local group. This amounts to about 1% of the galactic stellar population. Gaia also orbits around the L2 Lagrangian point, as you can see in this picture, which shows the orbits of the James Webb Space Telescope in white and Gaia in yellow around L2. And on February 18th, Gaia managed to spot the newcomer and catch an image of it on the very first try. Very little reflected sunlight came Gaia's way, and the Webb therefore appears as a tiny faint speck of light in Gaia's two telescopes without any details visible. Gaia is not designed to take real pictures of celestial objects, ESA noted. Instead, it collects very precise measurements of their positions, motions, distances, and colors. However, one part of the instruments on board takes a sort of sky image. It is the finder scope of Gaia, also called the sky mapper. The sky mapper scans a narrow 360-degree strip around the entire celestial sphere every 6 hours. The successive strips are slightly tilted with respect to each other so that every few months, the entire sky is covered, touching everything that's there and that's bright enough to be seen by Gaia. That's quite impressive, but what's more important is this image. I know you probably aren't an astronomer, and to your eyes, this picture may say nothing special, but this picture really shows that JWST is working properly. Every other dot you see in this image is a galaxy somewhere out there, with millions of stars, and every image from every instrument has a lot of different dots on them. Hang on, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel by clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Believe me, all the observations are going to be absolutely amazing. We will see the universe as we never did before. But James Webb will also help us unveil secrets of our own galaxy, the Milky Way. This is because the telescope works best in the infrared domain of light. Moreover, James Webb will provide us with mind-blowing results on exoplanets and nearby planetary systems. It's funny how we always talk about such discoveries as something that will happen in the remote future, but be aware that the future is already happening. In fact, the telescope seems actually ready to go. From now on, only minor changes to the mirrors are going to be done, depending on the orientation the telescope will assume according to its own motion. James Webb will effectively start its mission during summer because even if the telescope is in general ready, every instrument has to be wisely calibrated and every individual team has still a lot of work to do in order for the James Webb to perform at its best. Earlier we said Webb will change its orientation during its motion, but why is that? Is there a particularly good reason why it's going to change its orientation in space? Well, as we've already said, we want our telescope and instruments to be as cool as we can. This can be done by limiting the amount of solar radiation hitting the instruments. One way to limit this is indeed changing the orientation of the observatory. Webb uses a large sun shield to block light and heat from the Sun, Earth, and Moon, and its position near the Sun-Earth L2 keeps all three bodies on the same side of the spacecraft at all times. The five-layer sun shield, each layer as thin as a human hair, is constructed from Kapton E, a commercially available polyamide film with membranes specially coated with aluminum on both sides, and a layer of doped silicon on the sun-facing side of the two hottest layers to reflect the sun's heat back into space. Accidental tears of the delicate film structure during testing in 2018 were among the factors delaying the project. The sun shield was designed to be folded 12 times so that it fits within the Ariane 5 rocket's payload fairing. Because of the sun shield, JWST does not have an unlimited field of regard at any given time. The telescope can see 40% of the sky from one position and can see all of the skies over a period of 6 months, the amount of time it takes to complete half its orbit around the sun. But the most important part is going to start in the summer when Webb will start 460 hours of observations. During these 460 hours, Webb will try to provide us with brand new knowledge about six main topics, such as galaxies and intergalactic medium, galaxies, massive black holes, planet formation, stellar physics, and stellar populations. All we want is for us to have these programs observe things really quickly and release all of their data as fast as possible so that scientists can start working on data reduction and come to some new conclusions. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. What do you think about this video? Are you in love as we are with the James Webb Space Telescope? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.